Hi, in this video, let us learn how to create this beautiful photo tone effect to add some text to your photos. I got this idea after watching one of the design ideas that come as part of Microsoft PowerPoint. You can always find that if you have Office 365 subscription by going to Home and by clicking on Design Ideas, you will have a whole bunch of options available. And the one that I'm talking about is this. The limitation of this design is you are restricted to just this one style. Once you know how to create this kind of a style for yourself, then you can have the effect the way you want. So I'm going to show you how to create this effect all by yourself. It's a very simple thing to do, and once you learn how to do it, you will have total freedom. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. Here I am on a new slide with blank layout. Let us create the paper tone effect. Let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery. Let me pick up the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle which has a vertical orientation like this. It is quite easy to create this tone paper effect when we have this vertical orientation of the rectangle. Let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From lines, let me use this tool called as the scribble tool to create the effect. Then click so you can start scribbling. Now you need to scribble very fast while having small variations in your hand strokes. You can see that it is almost like you have a shaky hand, and then just keep shaking your hand like this, and then you make a shape around the rectangle. Now we have these torn edges. Let me select this piece here, which is the rectangle piece. Hold the shift button down and select the scribble that we had just created, and then go to Shape Format, Merge Shapes, and go to Shape Subtract. Now you have this torn edge. Let us do that again. Go to Home, go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the scribble tool once again, and then start scribbling. It's a thing that comes when you have a bit of a practice. Now we have scribbled it quite nicely and created the shape. Select this rectangle, hold the shift button down, and we have the second shape selected. Go to Merge Shapes and say Shape Subtract. Now we have created this piece, which forms this portion here. Let us rotate this to the right by going to Arrange in the Home tab and say rotate right 90 degrees. And then let us place this so it covers the area end to end. And then let us extend this a little bit further to create that torn effect. Let me add a photo in the background by going to Insert. Then go to Pictures and you can choose one of the stock images. If you don't have Office 365 subscription, you can use any of your sources to insert a photo of your choice. Let me select something, maybe something like this, and say Insert. Make sure that the slide covers the area end to end. So let me go to Crop and then go to Aspect Ratio and say 16:9. Now I have cropped it properly. Let me go to one corner and extend this so it covers the entire slide, and let me use Send to Back option. Now we have this area that will serve as our placeholder. Now I'm going to have this in white color. Go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. And to create that effect of torn paper, I'm going to add inner shadow. So let me go to Shape Effects, go to Shadow and say Inner, and this is the option we are going to choose called as Inside Center. Now, when I go to Slideshow, you can see that it looks like this piece is torn out of this photo in the background. Now, if you want to take this to the next level, you can always make another copy of this piece and have that as a background in a different color to give that organic look. When I go to the previous one, you can see that we have this shape here, which is in gray colored background, and that makes this torn effect look a little bit more natural. Now, all you need to do is to repeat the same process, make another shape by doing the scribble once again, and then have that as a background. So we have one piece here, and in the background, we have another piece. And if you see in the original slide, I have this inner shadow moved slightly up. So when I go to Slideshow, I won't really see these inner shadows in the vertical space. So when you do those simple adjustments, and when you add your text like we have done here, let me press Ctrl C and go back here and press Ctrl V, and I can always place this somewhere over here and then make my adjustments. Now, when I go to Slideshow, I have this nice looking torn photo effect. Now, if you observe closely, all these effects are the result of creatively applying the basic tools in PowerPoint. To help you hone your creative skills, we have put together a short playlist of creative custom animation tutorials. All you need to do is to click on the playlist here and start watching those creative animation tutorials. I can promise you it'll definitely be worth your time. So go ahead, click on the link and start watching those videos right away.